Welcome to audio-video system playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, will be going to explain you crystal microphone in this session. So this session is all about crystal microphone, and to explain crystal microphone, these are my session outlines, where in this session, first I'll cover basics of crystal microphone, then after I'll cover structure of crystal microphone. Then we will see elements of crystal microphone. Then after, I'll explain working of crystal microphone. Then we will see characteristic of crystal microphone. And then after, I'm going to explain features of crystal microphone. And I'll sum up this session by explaining applications of crystal microphone. Let us begin this session with first agenda. That is basics of crystal microphone. Now see, crystal microphone, that is working based on principle of piezoelectric effect. So this crystal microphone that works based on principle of piezoelectric effect. So in piezoelectric effect, all we do is we apply pressure on piezo crystal, and based on pressure it generates electrical signal. So that is the basic working principle which is there with this crystal microphone. So we will see that in detail how it is happening. See, difference of potential between opposite face of some crystal produces when these are subjected to mechanical pressure. So difference of potential that will be getting generated based on pressure which we apply it on crystal. So that is how piezoelectric effect is there. Now basically there are some categories of crystal which I have listed here, like quartz crystal, tourmaline crystal, rochelle salt crystal and ceramic crystal. Now see, when we talk about rochelle salt crystal, it is having high piezoelectric effect, but it is susceptible to moisture. So it cannot even withstand with high temperature like 50 degrees Celsius. So in moisture environment as well as in high temperature environment, we cannot use this crystal. But it provides high piezoelectric effect, means it is sensitive to the pressure which we apply it on it. Now quartz and tourmaline crystal, so those are low piezoelectric effect crystals. And when we talk about ceramic crystal, so that is more suitable crystal for microphone, as it is not susceptible to moisture and it can withstand high temperature up to 100 degrees Celsius. So usually we use this ceramic crystal in crystal microphone, as it is not susceptible to moisture and it can withstand to higher temperature up to 100 degrees Celsius. So these are the basics which is there with crystal microphone. Now let us move further with structure of crystal microphone. Now one can see structure of it, and I think you might have seen this crystal microphone, right? So here there is protection gill, then after there is buffle, inside that there is diaphragm and connection is there, right? But if you see its internal structure, so that is like this, where this is what, diaphragm, and diaphragm is connected with spring. You can see this is spring that is connected with diaphragm. So when sound is applied from here, this diaphragm that will move like this, and that is connected with push rod. So this push rod that will push pressure on this biomorphic crystal. By black color one can see this is crystal, biomorphic crystal. So on this crystal, this push rod will push pressure. So because of this pressure applied on it, from here we can have electrical output. And that output is directly proportional to the pressure change which is happening on this crystal. And this entire structure that is supported by insulating support. So this is what support which we have it to provide insulating support with this entire structure. So this is how crystal microphone is there. And its working is based on sound pressure. So when you apply pressure from here, this diaphragm will get vibrate like this. And based on that vibration, it will be generating some pressure by this push rod on this biomorphic crystal. And based on that pressure change, it will be generating electrical signal over here.
So there are two electrodes which will be considered as output terminal from which we can take electrical output. So this is how structure is there. Now when we talk about elements, then crystal, that is the main element which we have, and it is cut along the certain planes from the slice. So we have some slices. If you want larger amplitude, or one can say more sensitive microphone, in that case we can have series of crystals connected in particular microphone. So if you increase number of elements of crystal, it will increase sensitivity of microphone. So metallic foil electrodes are attached to the surface, and that will be carrying potential difference to the output terminals. So there will be metallic foil electrodes which I have shown you. See, these are two electrodes, which is actually metallic foil electrodes, which is over here, and based on pressure it will be taking electrical output from here, right? So two thin crystal slices suitably cut are placed in insulating holder with an air space between them, and large number of elements are combined to increase EMF. So here I have shown you two slices, right? But one can have multiple slices to increase EMF. Now diaphragm, that is made up of aluminium and that is attached with push rod, which we have seen. Diaphragm that is made up of aluminium and that is attached with push rod. So you can see diaphragm and that is attached with push rod. So this diaphragm that will get move with respect to sound pressure, and that will push this push rod, and that push will apply to this biomorphic crystal. And the whole unit that is enclosed in protective case, so that will give protection to this crystal microphone. Now let us see the working. So working, as I have told you, that is based on piezoelectric effect. So sound wave compression, that will compress crystal even, and based on condensation and rarefaction, crystal is coming into tension as well as in extension, and based on that it generates pressure difference, and that pressure difference is getting translated into electrical signal by using piezoelectric effect. So that mechanical pressure will be proportional to electrical signal which is generated by crystal as per piezoelectric effect. So that is how it is functioning. Now characteristic of crystal microphone. Now see, sensitivity of crystal microphone, that is 50 millivolt SPL, 40.1 Pascal. And if you want to increase this sensitivity, one can use multiple crystal slices in crystal microphone. So it will increase this sensitivity in case of if you use multiple crystal slices. SNR, that is high about 40 dB. So it is having very good SNR. If you see its frequency response, so that is ranging from 100 Hz to 8 kHz, right? So its frequency response is there in the vicinity of 100 Hz to 8 kHz. So we can use that for standard microphone. Its distortion is less than 1%. So distortion is very low in this crystal microphone, but frequency response is poor. It is from 100 Hz to 8 kHz only. So we can use it for quality or standard microphone, but we cannot use this crystal microphone for hi-fi system. And when we talk about directivity, so it is omnidirectional, right? So its directivity is omnidirectional, and output impedance, that is very high. It is there in terms of 1 mega ohm. So output impedance of crystal microphone, that is 1 mega ohm. We cannot say it is good or bad. It is 1 mega ohm. So further circuit that should be having impedance of 1 mega ohm. So that adjustment that we need to have it when we have crystal microphone. So this is about characteristics of crystal microphone. Now let us see some few features of crystal microphone. So here we can speak in crystal microphone at close range. So from close range we can speak in crystal microphone. It is having very high impedance, as we have seen it in characteristic. It is having extremely high impedance. We don't need any external bias over here, so no need of bias supply. Don't use direct to the sunlight for long time, as we use crystal there. We should not use direct to sunlight for a long time, else this crystal functioning will get damaged. So crystal functioning will get damaged as if we use it for longer time under sunlight. And it is low cost microphone. So these are the features which is there with crystal microphone. Now let us see some applications which is there with crystal microphone. So we can use it for home recording system. We can use it for amateur communication. And we can use it for mobile communication. So these are the basic applications which is there with crystal.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you understood all those things which I'm teaching here. You can ask your questions and you can place your queries here on my channel. Definitely I'll try to solve all those queries which is required to be solved over here, and based on that in future I'll make videos based on your queries. As well as you can download all this material which I'm teaching here from my application, and that material will be helpful to you to study engineering subjects. There are so many subjects which I have covered, and I have placed material regarding that on my application, so you can download it free of cost from my application. Thank you so much for watching.